Okay, we're going.
Hello!
I gave him 10 weapon conversions.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Adventures of Kaldari.
Where Alan decides that maybe he should have not chosen a boss fight for today.
Oh, nah, it'll be fun.
We'll be okay-ish.
It'll only be the fourth time we've killed this guy.
So the robot eye guy?
It'd be three. Well, he was dead to start with.
Oh, he's another.
In history.
Yeah.
Is he
Dragon undead? Wars. And then...
Oh, this guy.
And then on a boat. And you technically didn't kill him. He ran away like a coward.
Oh, he did get away.
Maybe yeah, he got teleported back to their flying ship.
Maybe that's why we're fighting.
Did you remember
him.
That? Yeah, his boat technically is supposed to fly.
I know.
Oh.
It is on here.
Oh, that is on there?
Yeah.
So you did remember.
It's a Peter Pan boat.
Yes, it is a Peter Pan boat. It's that green one.
Really, a cargo?
No, it's not. Oh. I just don't have more browns, which is what you have. But his is huge. So all the greens are technically cargo.
Sailing ships.
Technically cargo, but in right now they're sailing ships.
I think we're outgunned.
You guys have an entire fleet behind you. This is just for looks.
Visualization.
Yeah.
This is just a small section of the sea.
Because I ran out of all the other ones.
Besides really small.
Besides all of the rowboats. Well, they're the small ships. Last we left off. Do you want to find a role-playing question for us a little while I do this?
Sure.
Last time we left off, you guys were in a unnamed city on the south of that Afrain.
That continent.
That continent. I always forget that continent. I remember all of my named continents because most of them start with S. Shattered Isles, Salen, Citril.
Did you do that on purpose?
Nope. And then Espera, the second letter is an S. I didn't name that one though. That was James. But last we left off, you guys were in there, near the Santa Claus hat of trees on the south of the Middle Island continent. Russell's head's in the way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like, the little Santa hat.
Little Santa hat of trees.
Yep.
Santa hat.
Right there.
The trees at the bottom.
Yes.
No.
No.
Trees. Left.
On a frame.
Oh.
There.
That's why I was looking over there on the...
Nope. You guys were gifted a huge ship and the manpower to man it. So that you guys could go and take on the... Pirate King and find the Pirate Island. And that is where we pick up. But we will start with a role playing question for you three.
Oh, wait. Just kidding.
Momentarily.
Since Arvo kind of just like fell into the background because it's hard to remember.
She kind of just. Stands there for
me. If you guys start dying, I'll start teleporting you out with her, but that's about it. That's all she's been good for is vortex warp.
This time I'll let it happen willingly.
Right.
I'm dying! Help me!
Okay. How do you enjoy spending your alone time?
Okay, Meg.
it's just random chance after the fifth roll.
Thaddeus here. Alone time. I love swinging from rope to rope above everyone. Usually when I'm bored, I'll just go from mast to mast. And if there's only one mast, I'll just spin around in it. And then slowly unravel. spin around in it.
Slowly unravel.
I'm surprised you don't get nauseous.
I'm on the sea. It can't happen.
He is nauseous incarnate.
I am in nauseating.
Facts.
That we're drinking.
Yeah, something I'm coming. Alright, I'm playing Ravek Tobrain. Tobrain? Anyways, not important.
He has a tall brain.
I like spending my alone time
nerd
working with glass. If I'm not on the boat. Target practice is always fun.
It was 100%, so it was vibrating. And I was like, what's going on over here?
I am not the target practice.
No.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
And occasionally fishing.
Nice. Amora.
And I guess that leaves me, Amora, one of the triplets. What I like to do if it's dark, look at the stars and study them. Or when I have a lot of downtime, practicing medical spells.
What a good cleric.
Even though she's
in
snipe.
All the history of Tal'Zaro, she has been one of the best clerics.
I tend to
had
hit.
A whole campaign where we had a different cleric.
I mean, every campaign we have a cleric, and they're all just
dumb luck. We didn't have a cleric.
I guess you guys had a paladin, technically.
He's a jerk.
He's a jerk. It's true. Okay. Did you go Celestial Warlock too?
What? Yeah, I was. I only healed myself.
Oh yeah, that's right. Works healer. So I guess every campaign you've had a healer.
Yes. There's a problem.
There's the way to say it.
Not all of them heal.
And I wouldn't say... Actually, best healer I'd put is Mr. Pipe.
Okay, that is true. I will take that one. I will gladly take that one. I'm not as good of a sniper as you.
Best cleric, definitely Amora. But best healer, Mr. Pipe. But he cheated with the staff.
Yes, yeah, the staff.
I would define cleric and best in their own terms.
No.
Because Farnan was like the best of the best.
Good comedian.
Comic relief. Best comic relief.
Cleric, most mischievous.
No.
Trying to dig myself out of a hole.
No. He was always digging himself into holes.
Oh, he was.
Or climbing into trees.
But hugging
trees.
He was
trees. Digging holes for pumpkin seeds is what he was doing.
Yeah. That is true.
Yes, before we left, I would like to purchase a catapult and some pumpkin seeds and...
crap, that would be in there.
Pumpkin seeds?
Okay? Yeah,
that's the continent.
Oh, yes! Purchasing pumpkin seeds.
No, we're not.
I will go out of my way to purchase pumpkin seeds.
Too bad, we're already on sea.
Dang it.
You guys have been in port for 2 weeks, so I'll give you guys a higher percentage.
2 weeks?
Oh. Well, a week and a half.
That gives me another day to add more...
Where words. Did your sheet go? There it is.
Is it enough to get me any weapons? I don't know. Let's find out.
Okay, yeah, she can find pumpkin seeds.
Yes!
But you have to remember, it takes 1 minute to grow.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to take us a while to get across the board.
Well, and Thaddeus doesn't really know what to do with pumpkin seeds, so he buys the pumpkin seeds, knowing that they're magical.
Okay, probably we'll roleplay this as a good point. Okay, so you're meandering around town, the ship's being upgraded, it's a really big ship. You win it in a drinking game?
That's how you would come across them.
Okay.
People wager whatever they can.
Okay. You go to a bar. And you meet a fairly old halfling. He is extremely well-dressed. And he looks like he overly decorates. Like in on Earth, pumpkins and spice is overrated. This guy takes it to the next level. Smells like pumpkin, looks like pumpkin.
Weird tone.
Using Hogarth, he's a rock gnome, not a half
gnome. Oh, he's a gnome?
He's a rock gnome specifically. He's very dark skinned.
Never mind. He's a rock gnome. It's alright. And his clothing is atrocious on him. He's got a lot of oranges and greens.
Yep.
I didn't realize he was a rock gnome.
Yep.
It's been a while.
Yep.
But yes, you see him sitting in a bar. Just this small little person who looks like he's sipping at some wine. Very sophisticated, like. You look like an odd fellow. Would you like to have a drink?
You look like an odd fellow too. I would take you up on that drink.
Well then, I'll have another drink over here. The waiter comes over and sets it in front of you. What brings someone of your caliber to town?
You see, we're gathering a lot of ships, and I totally forgot why we're gathering all the ships. The captain knows, but yeah. I thought I'd walk the town because, you know, I always need a drink.
Ain't that the truth? And talking about gathering ship, it's because apparently you guys are invading the pirate homeland. So, oh boy.
I'm just watching Russell update his ship.
You told me a week and a half, so I had an extra 3 days to get me 5 more points. Arcane Mortar only costs 6. And I had 2 left over from before, so.
You're loaded.
Now I just need to add another energy cell. I'll just throw a little large on there, that's fine.
Easy enough.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah. So,
to us!
To us! Drinks it.
Another!
He keeps the rounds coming if you want to make your, I don't remember what you used. Your wisdom.
Yes. Wisdom versus constitution.
Ooh.
He
goes downhill quick.
That was a very promising face.
Yeah, he got, I don't know what his constitution is, so I'll just give him the
3 or 4.
Plus 5 or 6. I'll give him plus 6. So,
He was a barbarian fighter.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. Probably around there. He became a pumpkin farmer pretty early on. So the first one was 22, the second one was a 16, and the next was a 9. He's a lightweight. Extremely lightweight.
Every drink I get better. Because it was a 16, a 20, 21, 24.
That's pretty impressive. He's just over here on the third drink. You know, you're a great guy. Just eats it. And it's a long ways down for him. He was sitting on a booster seat.
I'll help him back up, put him in his little booster seat.
He's made out of pumpkin.
It is finely carved, preserved pumpkin.
Stacking the mugs one on top of the other so that he has a little barrier.
No support.
Well, I like you.
Opens it up.
Yep. Not my money pouch. Take these.
It's fine. I'm already footing the bill.
Ah, thank you. Yeah. Hey, somebody take me to my room. And you watch as this, like, farmhand comes over and is like, okay, sir, let's go.
I'd like another drink.
Give him another drink. Have a good one. Don't get shot. Those cannons hurt.
I haven't been hit by one yet.
I think you have. I think you deflected it.
Yeah. You went and he was raging, panda. So the damage he did take was like very minimal.
If any.
I think he took like one damage afterwards.
Yes, something like that.
It was deflect, threw it back at the person.
Yes. But yes, you are left with a bag of, let me grab a better dice.
One.
Okay, not that many dice. It's got 7 pumpkins.
Sweet.
You got 7 minutes worth.
That means if we light all the torches, we will last. It'll be 12.
That's not how that works.
We have 12 hours of torches. That only works if you light them one at a time. No way.
So good. What?
During my Baldur's Gate, I usually put it on mono mode instead of surround.
So I'm gonna go find the farmhand, ask him what the bag is for.
He's just like, they're Hogarth specialty. They're pumpkin seeds.
Oh, like you eat them?
No, don't eat them. You plant them, and magical things will happen.
Oh.
He looks down at your pouch. Kind of like your bag of tricks, but a little bit different. Usually has more of a surprise that may or may not hinder you.
So if I pull it out of this bag and I throw it...
Nothing will happen. You have to plant it in dirt, give it a little bit of water, and after a minute, something will happen.
Oh.
Potentially.
Cool. Something will tie both of those bags together. Tie it to my belt of hill giant strength.
Alrighty, now you have a bag of pumpkins.
Joy.
And now I'm gonna go find some dirt and another bag.
Damn.
It's not an episode of Caldera without pumpkin seeds.
Without some magic item that's broken.
Well, we can't have. What's it called? Climaxes without pumpkin seeds, apparently.
First try. I found the table for pumpkin seeds.
Hey!
Yeah, keep that page open. You're gonna need it.
Well, I'm gonna roll for the dice. Or I'm gonna roll every single time which bag I actually go into first.
Oh, which of the two bags?
Well, I'm getting a third for dirt.
Third for dirt?
Okay. So that's three.
Yes.
And then I'm going to get a fourth one for something to hold the dirt with the pumpkin seed.
Can you climb into these bags?
No. No, they're just little pouches.
Okay, I thought it was like a bottomless pit.
No. Oh, wait, no, I have... Do I have one? I do not have one. I do not have a bag of holding.
No.
Forget what it's called. I just call it the bag of bottomless pit.
Portable hole.
More hole of bottomless.
Oh, I do have a portable hole.
Yeah, so you guys were able to buy 2 portable holes. So the weeks passed. You guys outfit your ship. It is absolutely massive.
I'm gonna put dirt in the portable hole.
Oh boy. Let's see if we can break a portable hole. Let me give you guys the dimensions of your ship.
So I just have the 2.
You just have the 2?
The 2 bags.
And a portable hole?
And a portable hole.
Okay, so you go outside of town, find a nice little pouch of dirt, and start scooping it in. People are on the walls, it's like, what is going on? I don't know about these adventures. They're out there.
Word gets back to the captain. You do know the guy with the bunny ears? Digging up a hole.
I can see him right now.
I can see him on my eye. So yes, it is 150 feet long and 35 feet across. So, bigger than this house.
Except for this direction.
for the Potter of the Hole?
No.
No.
Your ship.
Ship, okay. I was like, whoa.
Oh, actually, it probably is about the same as... That's...
I'm pretty
that's
sure
pretty
it's...
Close. That might be...
Bigger.
It's a pretty big ship.
It's a really big ship. I think it has like 3 or 4 decks. Like, it's a lot of decks. Oh. It's... And then underneath, so yeah, it's got like almost 5 decks. And 3 mats for you to swing on.
Just yes. Instead of the 2 that we had before. Oh no, we had 3 before. No, we only had 2 before. We were on a medium.
Yeah, we had 2.
Yep, you were medium and now
we
you're
skipped right up to large.
Huge.
3 masts!
Yep. But the time comes and you all set off. As soon as you leave the tide gates, you see ships everywhere.
The light was making you glow, Hannah.
That's not very hard.
She is a daytime glow stick, so...
but you guys...
You're like runners... reflective gear
behind his vest.
Yeah.
Redheads.
I was wondering why. I'm like, I feel like I'm very bright over here.
You were.
You put on a hat or put on your hood.
Whole room goes dark.
I'm Ember.
But the whole fleet sets out. How many of your ships are you bringing? All of them? Except for the cargo one?
Yeah, I don't need to bring that one, I think.
So we only have 2.
So 3 behind you.
Ravex Revenge.
You have Ravex Revenge, Bacon of Hope, and the Courageous.
I forgot we named it Bacon.
Yes!
We haven't named this ship.
Oh, the new one that we're loaning?
Yeah.
Oh, no, wait. Sorry. Bacon of Hope was the cargo ship.
Yeah.
The Serene Seeker is the other sailing
Serene
ship.
Serene Seeker.
The small sailing ship is the Serene Seeker.
Yeah, I didn't name that one.
The medium sailing ship is your Avax Revenge. Your warship is the Courageous. And, so what do you want to call this one? Ravax Last Stand?
Sure.
The please don't hurt me.
Prepare to die.
My name is Ravax.
You did not kill my father. Prepare to die.
You shot my eye. Prepare to die.
Dang it.
Hold your breath, count to 10, and swallow.
I gotta talk right now! Was like, wait a second. It's my turn. So, you guys gotta go all the way around. Golly.
Funny.
This is gonna be the best session.
Welcome to the sympathy
we're going
pregnancy.
Around.
And Anna.
Ta-da!
That's the montage scene.
Okay. So. You got it? Every time I open my mouth, say something.
That's pertaining to this.
So you guys, make your way up. Oh, didn't come yet. I was trying to get anything out before I... Is there anything you guys do on the way?
Together.
What would Thaddeus do?
That.
I hate you so much, you guys.
You're not supposed to be roleplaying my character.
Don't die.
Thaddeus would experiment with one seed.
Oh boy, okay.
Oh no.
We're all just like, oh crap.
And he throws it overboard.
Oh, we're not gonna see it. And it won't.
And it sinks.
It won't, yeah, it won't grow in the ocean. Because it needs to be in the soil.
Well, there goes one seed. Because I put it in the soil, compacted it, threw it over.
You're like, let's just cut out the middle, man.
Someone's like fishing and like pulls out a shambling pumpkin.
A waterlogged pumpkin.
I feel sorry for that guy.
Okay, roll your decanter.
This is not working out for you.
36. I totally forgot what these pumpkins do. I know one of them is a pyramid.
Oh no.
Pyramid's like the...
Yeah, pyramid's like top.
Hopefully I think 36 is like the pumpkin house.
I swear, if you put pumpkins on the boat...
What are they?
No, this is out at sea right now.
So, as you were going, you look overboard and you're like, yeah, let's place this out.
Well, I put it in.
Oh yeah,
you just like compacted it and threw it.
And you just watch it sink. It's like, oh wait, dirt doesn't float.
Definitely doesn't.
Make another palm feather. Take your water skin. Set it down. Watch it.
Two seats.
Two.
Minute goes by.
This 10-foot pumpkin appears. It's got this nice doorway in it.
I'm surprised.
That guy sitting there just like enjoying his nice new ship.
And then the crow's nest comes flying off of his ass. Oh, yeah.
You just hear. Good point. Make a dexterity save. Well, as you look up, as this the crow's nest becomes a pumpkin.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, food for days, y'all. Food for days.
Well, that's a nat 20.
You just see him like hanging there. Hey.
This is a sight that's normal. Climbing back up. Opening up the door.
I wish it wasn't.
I wish it wasn't. I shouldn't have looked up.
Just gonna look down.
Just look.
Eyes ahead. Focus.
Message comes your way.
For the next 8 hours, you travel with a giant pumpkin at the top of your mast. Your boat waves a little bit more, but it doesn't affect you other than that.
Well, hopefully no one gets nauseous.
So yeah. That happens for 8 hours.
Oh, now that I know the pumpkin does this,
guys, I'm out.
I'm just yelling from up there.
Hey guys, come on up.
I'll pass. Please don't plant pumpkins on my boat.
After 8 hours, the house just kind of like disintegrates and just plops to the deck.
Sitting on the top, starts slowly sinking. No, no, no!
Swab and dust. Dumpy?
Mm-hmm.
Stumpy.
Go over and, yep. Swab and Stumpy go over and, like, start cleaning all of the pumpkin guts off, just, like, pushing it all overboard.
The fishes are having a feast.
Oh, yeah. You're just, like, sitting there practicing your magic, and you're, like... You just, like, hear water splashing like crazy, and you, like, look overboard, and there's, like, all these fish just, like... just eating all of it.
I'll summon a grapple cannon next to the edge of the boat to shoot down and pull them up.
Oh! Oh, yeah! Okay. Pumpkin's good.
Can I do it again, Captain, if we get this result?
Preferably not.
Preferably not. That means there's a chance. I'll run it past you.
2 to 8 hours in advance, though. So.
A couple days later, as I'm running past him, planning if I can see.
Right now?
It's just like, wait, what?
We don't know what that does. I'll wait till we get closer to
to the
chaos.
As you guys start seeing the floating island, well, islands, technically, up ahead of you. They're very easy to see from very far away, because they are over a mile in the sky.
Several miles thick.
Those are tiny.
So yes, you're just like, that's weird.
Just like, pinch out of here.
Play with it, bro. Oh, crap.
Oh, I can actually.
I broke it.
Go back home.
More island falls. Defeated the pirates.
Problem
solved. We have a big sunken date problem now.
Marlin, can you just, like, drop the island?
Not, like, permanently. You can bring it back up in a little bit, but...
For, like, 20 minutes.
Whole east continents just flood.
Yeah.
I still have a dragon.
You do have a dragon. It's sea adorable. Dragon.
Yeah.
It is just, like, chilling.
Yes, I mean, it's horrid.
Yes. In its little whole horde bucket. Barrel.
Every day going by, dropping in a copper piece, flicks back out.
Fine.
Gold piece.
Wow, you're an arrogant one.
Only the best. Rylak tries getting rid of silver pieces. Throws him at the back of his head every time he falls asleep in his chair.
Copper pieces, immediate. Silver pieces?
I will wait to inconvenience you.
Delicately put the mast on the boat. Oh!
So yes. As you guys start approaching it, you can see... several ships in the distance, kind of just like going back and forth, just like surveying isn't the right word.
Observing?
No, they're like
patrolling.
Patrolling. There we go. Patrolling the waters.
We see them on our maps long before they see us.
Oh yeah. You see him long before that.
Captain, I got a slight question.
Yes.
Wouldn't they notice something's off when they look at their maps and see a whole bunch of people on it?
Yep. By that time, there's nowhere for them to go.
And
they'll see you in real life long before they see you on the map.
Yes.
Oh.
They just see a bunch of ships. As soon as you guys get within range, it's like, oh, they brought the entire guild. Ah, crap.
Are we, like, cloaked or something?
Nope.
You, the guild have upgraded your guys' maps so that it can see further.
Mm-hmm.
I think you guys have, like, a 10-mile radius or something like that.
Which is about when they can see us in person.
Yes. So... by the time they see you in real life, you can already see them on your maps. Never mind.
We're at 5, aren't we?
You're at 15-mile radius.
Oh, never mind. We see them long... 5 miles before they see us in person.
Yes. On your eye, you just start tracing a good half dozen ships. It takes them a while to patrol. But as you get closer, you can see several more... underneath the island.
Can't we just like just create the track of what we need to do by the way they follow?
No, not really. Once we get within a mile or so, they'll start shooting.
think it's that one.
Yeah.
That you guys needed to make it to.
It's we're heading like
yeah all over there.
Right. You hear what from the ship a little ways away. Now, prepare yourselves. We feast on our enemies today. You look over and there's just like this dwarf on a stool steering the ship.
Would you like a little boost?
I've got a boost. I'll boost your butt overboard if you want.
I can make you a house out of pumpkin.
I'm just like...
I think I'm good. 1 second, let me check if he knows what it is. I don't care for vegetables. Especially not to live in them. But to each their own.
Yeah, I wasn't persuasive at all. It was a 2. Total.
But you guys start getting closer. And you watch as one of the ships... Well, you mostly watch... with your eyes. Everybody else is kind of just like looking forward. You watch as one of them it starts coming out from under the island, and you're like looking under the island, but you don't see it, but you see it on your map. So then you look up and it's like right underneath the island, kind of just like following its curvature, flying.
I'm glad I installed the moor.
Cannons don't shoot up. They do in cartoons. There's more sunken ships from cannons firing up than any other ship, than any other weapon.
That's not normal out there.
Keep your eyes on the skies, guys. They got some flying vessels.
But you watch as several of them start turning and making their way towards you guys. Some of them are pretty well armored. Oh, I moved my spot. The singing bane. Nope. Yes. Ravak, on your eye, you receive 2 messages. 2 hails. One of them is from the Cursed Doom. The Cursed Doom, the Black Skull. The Destroyer. This ship is built to sink multiple ships. Then the other one you get is...
How do ships fly again?
It's just an upgrade. It's a magical upgrade.
Like enchantments?
Yes.
Pixie dust.
Yes. It should be in the upgrades. Is it not?
Do you believe
it? No, it is. I was just thinking about it.
Yeah, it's all magical.
All the pirates on there.
Just trying to decide how they steer. If they still use a rudder, or if at that point they have some other means.
I feel like at that point it'd be some other means.
Kind of like a wind method.
It would be more of a captain's chair. Kind of like the spelljammer. And the other ship you see is the Disrupting Angel. From Icebringer.
Happy you didn't say Weeping Angel.
Hunter of the Hunter, Navy Breaker, and Soft.
And soft.
And soft.
He's a habit of leaving people alive.
Yes. He takes out the guild and the navy, but he leaves them alive. But those are the two you are hailed by, because they recognize Ravak.
Weird.
Weird.
That's not creepy at all.
Do their hail say anything, or is it just like, hey?
We recognize you. That's pretty much all they do. Is it tells you who they are to try and instill fear. It's like a, hey, we've got two of our top dogs here. Turn around. Just walk. I'd say walk away, but sail away.
We've got Nomura. You can't scare us. And an Adora and an Alora. They're scary within themselves.
Triple threat.
Okay, but those are the two hails you see in your eyeball. It's like, well, now's a good time to die. All hands on deck!
Wait, I didn't know this was about dying.
You watch as the other ships, like, everybody starts gathering on deck and getting their cannons loaded and ready. Well,
and the cannons.
Let's do this.
Pull out my broom.
Okay, so you guys will each be controlling a ship.
Oh boy.
They will pretty much just have the same stats as Russell's. You'll just have large cannons just to keep it simple. You just won't have as much health.
That's fine.
Which one is going to be... Oh, he's this one.
He's that one.
How high do you want him?
Yeah, give him that one.
Here's the sticky deck.
It's fine. I'm good at balance.
Perfect!
Now he can't be seen.
That's okay. He's invisible.
We know.
He can never hide.
No, he can't hide from you.
We know he's there.
The dart's larger just because he's up in the air.
Each of these is 35, right?
I thought it was 30.
Each square?
Yeah,
30.
Looking at about.
Does everybody roll initiative? You have incredible initiative.
Yes,
right?
I got a 12.
Total?
Yes. I rolled a 4.
That is
23.
Holy cow. Amora?
20.
And 13.
I've had two decently high rolls. I'm very positive. It's gonna come to bat me in the bottom.
Okay. You're wasting on your high rolls.
Please don't hurt me.
Okay, here we go. So, Thaddeus, you're up first.
If you have three spaces, approximately.
One space.
You can move them a little bit closer if you want to bring those guys into camera.
No, they're all in camera. It's just because he's so high.
Oh, yeah. Just bring him forward like 5 or 6 or something.
Because we are all in firing range, technically.
Yes.
Sorry. I was trying to move it.
So, you each get 3 shots.
And it's within how much of range for cannons?
Oh, we're easily.
Oh, 800.
And what am I adding to each shot?
6.
21. 25. 20.
Okay, who are you aiming for?
That guy.
That guy? Okay.
Straight in front.
Yes. We'll just do average damages. I don't have a marker. Hello, marker.
3 hits. I'm guessing.
Oh, yeah. 3 hits. Absolutely. Holy caramba.
I'll go last.
You got a 12.
It's garbage.
I got a 13. Okay.
Don't mind me as I take a nap.
Okay, Amora.
Roll this 3 times.
Who am I?
This one.
You're this one. You can move.
Yeah, it's just one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, technically.
If you wanted to use
firing would be more like this.
Yes.
That works.
Like this 3 times?
Yep.
Don't mind me, guys.
What are you doing?
That marker doesn't work.
Centrifugal force.
24.
Yes.
16. 17. Which guy are you aiming for?
I'm
gonna pick off that guy.
Yeah, we'll go with this tiny.
Okay.
You are very nice to us. Keep it up.
Okay, those are the average damages.
Pew pew pew!
So, that guy up there is going to, he watches a figure kind of just like jumps overboard. Sploosh. He gently glides, but yes, sploosh. and then
he must be a monk with featherfall.
You wish. Oh, you are definitely within range of the mortar.
Yeah.
Mortar. Ooh, dear. Oh. Ha ha!
Cheater! Triple well, advantage!
They keep rolling off the freaking table.
Play it where it lands!
You watch as this giant, like, fireball comes straight for you, and you're just like, ah, crap.
See? Deflector missiles!
I
don't remember how they work.
Yes, they activate and do something. They reduce damage.
If I was in the air in my room and I activate the cube of force,
wouldn't you just go
deflector missiles?
Into the
2d6 per charge. Max of 3. I'm gonna spend 3 charges.
Okay. 3 charges. 3 energy missiles fly at it.
Okay, good. Bad. Terrible.
17.
17 total?
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Yep.
That.
The first roll was so promising.
First roll was really good. And then there was 2 wins.
It just reduced from the bludgeoning.
Yeah. It would reduce the bludgeoning. I'm just trying to see if you're... Your threshold is hit.
Oh, by the bludgeoning?
Yes. Because if it's not, I'm just going to say it gets pushed overboard. And you don't have to worry about any of the damage. Nah, it still hits. But it is reduced by 17, so it's only 26.
27 bludgeoning damage. And then all creatures within 10 feet.
Let's see. Where are they aiming for?
How close it is to you, yes. They're aiming for the back of the ship. So, make your dexterity saving throw.
Interference.
Darn phone.
That was way worse.
Sometimes you want to take the interference.
Right.
Four.
Four? Yeah, no. Oof. You take 10 fire damage and 17 piercing damage as it explodes and just shrapnel goes everywhere. Bits of your ship are on fire and your crew is sitting there like trying to put it out.
Go stomp it!
Go stomp it! You got this, little guy!
Wait, how much damage?
27.
27? Okay.
Yes.
I didn't like that.
What was it? Okay. So.
I picked up a little laser thing for shocking the water around me.
That would have been funny. okay. That is his turn. Next guy is going to shoot the other guy.
Here, let me move them all a little bit closer.
Yes. Move them all a little bit closer. Cannon fire just.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. One misses. So, your guys' two ships get slammed.
These
not
two?
Yours. Yes, the other two get slammed. By some pretty big cannons. But we'll worry about the damage. Trying to keep it quick. Okay. Now
my
it's your turn.
Yay. Okay.
Shoot it out of the sky.
Okay. Actually, yes. I would like to use a mortar shot here.
Oh, okay.
So aim for that. Is that one plus six as well?
Yes.
Okay.
All of your people are just...
Actually, no, you weren't nice to me. I'm going to roll a different dice. Oh, yeah, natural. Ooh. 20.
Direct hit. It's just, like, right into the front of his ship.
And I'm going to spend three as well on that one.
Okay. You're down 3-6 charges.
Yep. I mean, it's not a lot of damage. I guess it gets double, huh?
Yeah.
I guess I can roll it. Well, we can take it. Let's just do average for quickness. Because it's 9 plus... Or 9 times...
3. So 28.
3, it's 27, uh-huh. But then it's doubled per the crit, so 54.
54.
Ow. Yeah.
Not bad. Nothing compared to what you guys did. You guys did 225.
Oh, I'm not done.
Yeah.
That was one shot.
One shot.
Alright, and then I'm going to shoot... Is that the other...
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to shoot him with two long cannon shots.
Okay. Bang, bang.
Into the room.
Okay, one's a miss and the other one's a hit.
Okay.
So that's another, what is that? 50 or 78 damage to him.
78 damage to him. Okay. That is your turn. Okay. So it is now your guys' turn. Move.
Bloop.
Ah, keeps kicking that. I almost need, like, one of those long
14
things. Yes. Barely hits.
10?
No.
13.
Nope.
Wow. That was a rough
one.
78 damage. Damn.
You're a little warship.
I already moved you.
Okay.
78.
25.
Yeah.
Nat one.
No, that does not hit.
Fired on the opposite side. Fire! 11.
Wrong one! No, 11 misses.
Wow. Oh, 17. One good hit.
Who's she shooting?
She shoots the Naga. Okay. We're picking off the sides.
Okay.
Not really worried about the sides.
Right. So, as you guys keep getting closer, that is your turn.
Realized he'd be wanting to start maneuvering.
Yeah. Maybe just... Yeah, there we go. Fire, turn back this way, and then turn the other way.
It's just like...
That's why he missed
too. The hexagon map works better for ships.
Oh, way better.
And we'll switch to that for any future naval.
Space or navy battles are going to be on hex maps.
That was way better.
So, another mortar fire for you, and another mortar fire for a couple other people. That is also another hit for you. So, roll your dexterity saving throw.
Oh, I better reduce some damage. I'll spend another 3. Wait, does this have... Oh, it does have... Never mind, I'll use the average. For simplicity's sake. 12... 18. So just... 18 reduction.
18 reduction?
Yep.
Okay.
And my deck save this time is going to be
a... Do you have reflector missiles for your arcane cannon? Did we give those to you?
I can. In fact, that's not a bad idea. Maybe I do that. I can summon that. Where's that written?
What the heck do I know?
Okay, it's in a Google Doc somewhere. Because I'll do that. After the first one, I'm like, no. Let's see if we can reduce this damage even more.
Artillery's cannons. A cannon readies itself to protect the carrier. The first attack that hits the target triggers the cannon to fire a missile that intercepts the attack, reducing the damage by 2d8.
Oh, but that's only if it's targeting me specifically. Up to you.
Will I'll it allow it.
Okay. So, 2d8 reduction?
Yeah. I will allow this. This is pretty epic.
Ooh, heck yeah. 12 more.
12 more on top of the 18?
Yep.
Wow. Okay. So, it comes flying at you, and the deflector missiles from your ship are just like, and you're like, wait a second. Poof! And it just barely misses your ship. And just... erupts in the water. Well done. Well done.
Good. Sorry. This is a good plan. My energy cells are going to be wiped.
But as you are focused on that, you hear... and you turn around, and there is a very large robot.
Judging by the way
that ship. Let me just grab a ship real quick. And we'll switch to onboard fighting while they all deal with that.
So, place your pieces where you'd be.
We're tiny.
I would be probably right here. Probably over here.
Yeah. I'm somewhere.
Ah!
Nope, that's Icebringer.
The Black Skull. But he pops up. You don't know how you didn't hear him earlier, but then you look at him, and he has these huge red dragon wings out of his back.
Oh, so he's not wet.
Oh, he was underwater.
Oh, okay.
But he came up out of the water and just landed.
Gotcha. So he is wet.
He is wet, yes.
Good.
And made a medal. Good.
That's what I like to hear.
So, yes. That is all he can do, is just land there. He has been dashing nonstop. Including legendary actions.
Impressive.
Yes.
Are we keeping the same initiative?
You can reroll for this one. Okay. All the other ships kind of like pass you guys because you guys kind of slow down. Your crew's still like firing off the distance, but I don't know where you put your mortar.
Well, if we had the full size one, it would be on. I figured it'd be on this second.
Yeah, layer. Second deck. Okay.
So we both got 18.
I'm guessing you have higher.
She does.
I do.
You have higher decks?
Oh, higher decks?
Yes.
Well, higher initiative, I guess.
She has higher initiative.
How does she have higher initiative if she has lower decks?
She must have the other feet.
She does.
Oh, okay. Then
the what? You
first. This is much better.
The what?
The alert feet.
What alert means you
have 25.
Oh.
To your initiative.
Oh, crap.
A proper number.
Good thing this guy has legendary action.
Right. That'll help his action economy.
Yes.
That's where I went wrong last time.
Flexing.
When I used him. He didn't have any legendary actions, which he should have to make it a proper boss fight.
Right.
Time to rage. Yeah, he probably likes that idea too.
Yes. He is raging. You see fire glowing inside of this burnt helmet. He's got scorch marks everywhere, just scratches. Giant dragon claw marks across his chest. He is wielding an oversized great axe. This thing is bigger than most of you guys.
This guy's terrifying.
He is huge.
I'm gonna punch his kneecap.
right.
So yeah,
that I use monk special move: punch kneecap. It's like stunning blow, except for it's very crippling.
There's a much more effective move, and that's punching the inner thigh.
Inner thigh punch. See, I told you.
It is totally sippic, man.
Have you watched that video?
No.
Okay. Tomorrow, we're watching.
Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow or Sunday, we'll watch it.
What is it called?
Inspired Guns.
I'll explain that to
you. Oh, okay. No, I have seen Inspired Guns. It was back when Jane and I first got married, or were dating.
We're going to watch that tomorrow.
So, like, yes. Almost 8 years ago.
If we can find it.
I have the DVD, and I know exactly where it's at.
Me too.
I have seen Inspired Guns. That's
what I want for a little priest activity once.
Painful. Painful and a half.
Oh, but funny.
No, it is funny. I died, but oh man, it was bad.
Alright, my turn.
Yep, your turn.
Lightning bolt to the face. Make a dexterity saving throw.
Okay, he makes that with advantage.
What is
that? Oh. They're both 15s.
He failed.
No, I rolled, so 19.
Total. Oh, gotcha. Never mind, he succeeds. He takes normal damage.
Oh, yay him.
one second. I think I still have a dice app. Yep. That's what my thing's faster.
Okay, that brings it to more.
I'm going to use Guiding Bolt.
After you get...
Okay.
There.
Oh, wait. Yeah.
What level?
Upcast.
Oh, no. There we go.
24 damage.
That's garbage. You rolled so many. That's it. Where's my wizard dice? Not using this app again.
He's going to use. Before your turn, he's going to use his legendary action to take the dodge action.
On which one?
Huh?
Yeah. He just before.
All attacks now have disadvantage on him. Until his turn.
Okay, so we'll roll.
Oh, that's fine. I'll just use it.
With disadvantage, she still gets 27.
27?
Yes, that hits.
Figured, since he's metal and he's wet.
It doesn't do any extra damage.
Dang it.
No, only lightning. And cold.
It was worth a shot.
Do I not have any bonus actions? No, because I'm using the deflector missiles. Yes. That's right.
Which will come in handy.
They're gonna save my bacon. For sure.
Yeah.
I don't think shield's gonna be the only thing.
96 for 36.
What?
36 damage.
36 damage?
Radiant damage.
Oh, okay. 30.
And he is now beaming.
Yes, the next attack now is regular. Used regular.
Sadly, I don't have any, like, one-shot moves.
No. That is the problem with monks. Unless you were to go, like, paladin. But you don't have the charisma for that.
Yeah.
Or the strength, because I think they need strength and charisma.
He does with the belt.
Ah, that's true, with the belt.
I definitely have the strength. Alright, I run up to him. I stand in front of the captain.
Captain Seven.
As I'm raging. And I'm going to punch his inner thighs.
Okay. Your hands hurt.
I get 4 punches.
First one is regular, the rest is disadvantage. First one's regular.
Yeah. Kind of helps. 20.
Barely hits.
Next hit is a...
These guys were menaces.
17.
That's a miss.
Next hit... is a... 26.
Definitely hits.
Next hit... is a... 11!
Yeah, that's a miss. So 2 hits. As you go up and it's like... Ding, ding! Oh! Ding, ding!
You're not as strong as you are when you're drinking.
Well, this guy's built to fight dragons, so...
27.
27
damage?
That's
to be expected. Okay, that's pretty good.
Oh, wait. He takes half damage.
Oh!
Yeah.
He's raging.
He's raging.
13.
I have a taste of your own medicine.
No.
Barbarians have been the best sailors.
Yes. They're really annoying. Did you already have Hannah's?
Hannah's isn't halved, it's magic.
Yeah. He's not a bear.
He's not Totem of the Bear. He's resistant to fire, poison, bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. Yes. Because he's a robot.
And a dragon fighter. So I did nothing to do it?
Yeah. Okay, just keep. It is asking. Now his turn.
We need to figure out what's wrong with
him. It was a good try.
You did plenty of damage to him. It's
going to take a swing at
me.
You? And then he's going to take a step over here and take a swing at Ravak as well.
I thought it was big enough.
No.
At least you know where he's at because he's glowing.
Holy crap. Yeah, that'll be a 30 to hit you.
No.
And a 29 to hit you.
Yeah, I can't stop that. So, deflector missiles it is.
So, deflector missiles it is.
By reaction.
Okay. So, you take, 11 slashing damage and 3 fire damage. How much do you reduce?
8.
8? Okay.
And just get mad for you, Captain.
So, 8.
Which is sad. I was hoping for better.
Technically below average, because average is now.
No, that's true.
So 8.
Yeah,
would put it at 14 slashing damage and 3 fire damage.
Total of 17.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And that is his turn.
All right. I like a simple man. My turn.
Yep.
Wait, didn't you use legendary, or what, did you already use a legendary action?
He regained all of his legendary actions
at the end of his turn. He just used one.
What did he do?
He used the dodge action.
Oh, that's right.
And it takes two legendary actions, and that's all he has.
Okay. He's back. Yeah, I couldn't. I was like, wait, he didn't attack.
No.
Dodge action. He's smart. Gotcha. Yes.
Not that it helps him with lightning, but...
No.
Lightning.
He has his danger sense. He is no longer wet. Evaporated no that.
Wet. Oh, in that case, I cast E-Metal.
Okay. That is a smarter idea. No. Once...
At third level.
Okay. Heat metal, you say.
There's no save.
Yes.
He cannot take off his
arm. He cannot
take off his arm. Actually...
He's resistant to fire.
Is the haft of his axe...
Oh, it's complete metal.
Okay. Then I will cast it on that.
Okay. Smart.
If the creature is... must succeed on a constitution saving throw or drop the object.
Is that on his turn or immediately?
Immediately.
Okay. Constitution saving throw. Something he's good at. That'll be a 24.
Okay. If it does not drop the object, he is disadvantaged on... attack rolls and ability checks until the start of your next turn.
Oh, he doesn't have... He doesn't take damage?
No, he takes damage.
But yeah, he's still holding it.
He still takes damage.
Oh, okay. I was like...
The only... He just... Because he chose to hold on, he now has disadvantage.
Interesting.
Smart.
Okay.
And... 10... 11, 12, 13, 14... 15 fire damage, so not seven. Much.
7 damage.
And I have to keep activating it.
Yes, it's every turn you have to use a bonus action.
Is it a bonus action?
Is it an
action? It is a bonus action.
I was gonna say, heat metal is a brutal spell.
This spell is broken as crap.
Yeah, why do you think Mr. Five had it? But nobody had metal on him, so it doesn't help. But yes, I always have that one when I'm going into fire because it is metal busted. Underwear.
Yeah, so now he is disadvantaged, which is convenient.
That is convenient. Well, I guess...
In fact, I guess I could have also cast it anywhere on him and you'd still have had disadvantage, but this way, there's a chance he has to pick up his weapon.
Yes. Yes, that is true. So, he will use a legendary action to make a swing at you with disadvantage.
Oh, fair enough. I'm gonna need healing.
She's already... crap. 16.
Nope. I don't even need to spend shield.
So I was like, I don't think he needs a shield for that one.
Nah. I deftly dodge out of the way.
He's like...
Stop hitting my axe.
I don't like that.
I thought you were into that kind of thing, judging by your physique.
No. His axe head is on fire. the handle's not supposed to be on fire, but it is now. okay, that is your turn, Amora. Adora? Amora.
Amora.
Yes, love, that's right.
I love you.
So, I'm actually going to go over to Ravak and use Cure Wounds.
Thank you.
Using her Staff of Healing.
Oh, I forgot we got her that.
And it was 28.
Oh, sweet.
Half healed!
More than half. Nice. 16 damage taken. Thank you, Amora!
Well then. He will use a second legendary action to retry that. That's more like it.
Wait.
28.
That hits.
You already used your reaction, so... Oh, never
no,
mind.
I regained it, so...
That's right.
I get to reduce this one.
I get to reduce this one.
Aha! This time, I reduce it by a whopping 12.
Ooh. Okay, that is 10 slashing damage and 4 fire damage.
Okay, so now I need to make a DC
10
saving throw.
1.
No, that's a 19.
Dang it.
Plus a 7, so I'm good.
Plus, I can actually give myself Stroke of Genius.
It's a
does that require
throw.
A reflection action?
Oh, actually, that might.
I don't
I'll
know.
Have to double check that. I think it does.
Not a reflexive action.
A reaction. Wait, how much damage was it again?
It would be
14.
14 total. So, not quite undoing what was done, but
it's a good hit.
It was his turn. Amora's turn. So for her turn, he did pretty good. So it is now your turn.
Punch, 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 punch. All at normal, right?
Yeah.
Yep, he didn't dodge.
16. Does that hit?
16?
No.
Oh,
shoot. He has an armor class similar to Rabbit.
19?
Nope.
Oh.
Like Russell said, he was built to be a menace.
27 and a 28 were the other two.
Yes, those are the same. He has an armor class of 20.
Fifteen is halved.
Okay.
Math in my brain. That's why I'm using it.
Right. Tell me what it says. Okay.
And I'm gonna say to him, I cast! Do not hurt me!
Did it work?
Wait, no. I cast Hurt Me. That's what I say.
Make an athletics check.
I am really great with athletics.
Oh, it's his turn.
It is his turn.
Be a 27.
38. He grabs you and chucks you overboard.
Bye, Thaddeus.
It's like... Don't judge you?
Okay.
Grabs Wait. You. Like, his whole hand just, like, goes around your chest, pretty much, and just...
I can spend a key point to use the dodge.
That
as a bonus action.
Won't help you. Oh, dodge? It still won't help you. He's grappling you and chucking you.
No.
And then he turns to Ravak. Does he make the save on his turn, or is it on your turn?
It's on my turn.
Oh.
Every time I use my bonus action.
When that's it triggers right. That's the right. Save. Does he still have disadvantage on attacking?
Yep.
Okay.
Until the beginning of my turn, and then I use my bonus action, and then it triggers it again.
Okay. So that one is a 23 to hit.
I use shield.
You used your reaction to deflect
his
axe.
Oh, I did. You're right. Never mind.
He is built to be a menace against you.
Well, if I didn't have the freaking deflector missile, I'd be a menace pushing him off the boat.
You would be pushing him off the boat. But you would also be nearly dead. Because it's been blocking almost... It's blocked 20 damage.
Yes, it has been nice.
Okay, so that is another 22 slashing and another 4 fire damage. So 26 damage. As he just smashes his axe into you.
Now I'm bloodied.
That is his turn. It is now your turn, right back.
Ah.
This is when he starts hurting.
Yes, bonus action. Make a con save.
Okay. Oh boy. 20.
Okay, yeah, he holds it.
Okay. Takes damage. You guys hear
18
just like cannon shots going off in the distance, waters going up and down. 18 halved is 9. Good job, guys. You broke the triple digits.
I'll give him another lightning bolt.
Okay.
Oh, wait, no, I can't because I used heat metal? Yeah, so I have to use a cantrip.
You're not cat. technically casting the spell.
Alright. In that case, I'll use the lightning bolt.
Okay.
I'll burn another third level.
Thaddeus, like, drops and lightning goes over his head, and it's like,
oh! I have slow fall.
I can sculpt.
Yes.
I can sculpt spells, so it would go.
That's true. The lightning just, like, goes around.
It's not a big deal. I'd use Thunder Wave on this guy, but I know his con is through the roof, so.
Yep. Okay, so dexterity saving throw. Oh, wait.
Legendary resistance?
No. He has advantage on dexterity saving throws. I was like, oh, man. He's
wait a minute. I think he.
I thought that was just attack rolls and skill checks.
I can't remember. Let me double check. I can't remember.
That'd be ridiculous if it was saving throws, too.
Yep, just ability checks. Yep.
Okay, you're right. Natural 20.
Once you do that. Okay.
So.
Half damage.
Yeah. 29. Lightning just
so garbage.
You failed me, Pikachu.
Just like, is that a Pokeball?
It is.
It's a Pokeball and a Pikachu. 18, 21,
20. It's 27, so 13. Pretty garbage.
I almost gave you an extra 10 damage.
Please do.
Please do. Okay. Legendary action. Disadvantage to hit you. Ah, yeah, not even close.
Oh, wait. I forgot to make my save.
Oh, for the last one?
For my concentration.
Oh, you might not even have taken that fire. Heat metal. It would have just been 10.
Yeah, so I passed.
I was like, you need to roll a 1 or a 2.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm good.
Yes, you're good. Okay, that's your turn. Amora.
Wait, what did he miss me? Someone
had... Oh, yeah.
Okay, good.
Hey, you got a 15.
Wow. You roll a 1?
No, you rolled a 4.
Oof, that's even scarier.
I gotta use the restroom, unless you're planning on killing me right
yes.
now.
Yes.
Okay. In that case, let me calculate health.
You need to tap it. Tap, 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 tap.
500 health.
Oh, it's like, man.
24. Nice, nice, nice. 32.
Stop healing him!
Alright, now I can use the rest.
Takes a step back or two, just so that way he can't get towards you.
1 second. He can make a reflexive reaction to attack her. He's got reach.
That's true.
So if she moves.
Do you want to move or stay?
Either way.
You'll have half cover. Do you want to move?
If I move, I can't heal him anymore because I have to.
No, you can still go back in and heal him.
Well, then move me out of dodge for a minute.
Okay. So he'll make his attack with disadvantage. You are so lucky because that was a natural 20, but he still hits you because that would be a 30 to hit. I rolled a 20 and a 19.
That's terrifying.
I only have 9.
That's fine. You'll survive.
You're not resistant to anything, right?
No.
No.
Okay. So you take. So you take the 22 slashing damage and 2 fire damage.
Can anyone heal me?
You feel a hand like touch your back and you're like, ah, and then it leaves you and he like swings his axe and it like slams into you, but its head hits Amora behind you as she tries to get out of the way. You make a terrible wall.
I know.
I gave her 3/4 cover too.
That's a massive axe.
It's huge.
And technically, yes. Arwill could technically heal you.
Yes, Arwill can technically heal you. Okay, so that was his reaction.
Don't you have mass healing?
Yeah,
you should word on that staff.
She does. Mass cure wounds.
Nope.
Way better than mass healing word.
But she's already used 8 charges.
Oh, you might not have enough for the, it's 5 charges.
Yeah, it is.
Thing. Does a 22 hit you? He's using his second legendary action to hit you.
No, I'll use shield. I haven't used my reaction.
Ah, darn. Hits her, and then comes back and just tries to hit you and this...
Wait a minute, he's already used his 2 legendary actions because he missed the first one right after my turn.
Right after your turn was 1 legendary action.
Yeah, he missed.
And then after... he used a reflexive action.
Oh, it was a reflexive action. Gotcha.
Second legendary action.
Yes, I will use shield.
Just like... like, you just like... see it fuzzing right in front of you, and you're just like, that was close. The fire just like crackling across the shield, and he pulls his axe back.
Let me hit you, little man.
Yeah, as soon as you hold still, let me hit you.
You've already hit me.
Okay.
No, you're not holding still enough.
You're up, Thaddeus. It's like slowly getting slowly. To the water. Sploosh.
Ha!
Well, by that time, I pulled out my broom, and I'm slowly raising up. I activate my cube of force.
And you move back.
Outside of here, and it engulfs him.
Oh, engulfs him?
Spells can pass through.
Okay, okay.
He cannot.
No physical objects, just spells. Oh boy.
Okay, okay.
This is clever.
And I jump over onto the ship, leaving my cube of force and the broom behind.
Okay, so you're next to him?
Next to him again.
Okay, that was your action.
Yes. I can still punch him once. Twice.
Nope. No. You have to use your action to attack for those. That's right. The one downfall of monks.
They changed it.
But I do feel a second wind coming on!
Yeah? Okay.
How's your hand?
Now you can activate your bonus actions.
Yeah.
All of them are at normal. That is a miss. That is a hit. That is a miss. That is a hit.
Okay.
Phew!
Smack, 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 smack.
Bing, bing, bing.
12 damage.
Woohoo! Was that halved?
Yes.
Okay.
Bad idea.
So he is staying in with me.
Can he move in there? Or is he like...
He can barely move. But he's in there with him.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
It's what you get! Like, you see the steam coming out of my ears. The hair just starting to stand up. Because the static electricity, but it looks like flames.
Okay, Albert Einstein.
Bunny ears.
Get engulfed by your standing here.
Oh. Okay. This guy's lived long enough to know. Okay, he's gonna make his attacks against you. He's gonna go reckless so that he has regular attack. Oh man, does a 13 hit?
No.
Dang. a 23.
Yes.
Okay. So he gets one hit on you.
I pissed him off.
So that'll be 11 damage and slashing and 4 fire. What type of barbarian are you? Did you multi-class?
I'm just first level barb.
Oh.
He's enough to rage.
Enough to rage. I was wondering if you had gone cat, totem bear.
That takes 3 levels.
Yeah, exactly.
I wouldn't be a fighter if that was the case.
Oh yeah, that's right. You multi-class twice. Brilliant build, but that's a lot of levels to put into something.
It is.
You're talking about... it has to be complex.
Yes. Okay, that is his turn. Did you say no physical matter can go through it?
Yep.
But spells can.
Spells can.
So that means he can't use his
But would he axe, know right? that?
Oh, yeah. He jumps onto your broom, and it starts to sink into the water and drag you down with it since you can't pass through.
You get an opportunity attack.
Ah! You do get an opportunity attack. But he just, like...
Also... Oh, no, I don't.
He, like, leans up against it, looks over at the cube stuck to the broom, and kind of, like, goes over and just, like, climbs onto it.
Bye.
Just sinks into the water with it because he is way too heavy for that broom.
He takes 4 damage.
4 damage. Okay.
That was pitiful.
But now you are being dragged along with the cube.
Bye, Thaddeus.
Bye.
Ever so slowly.
Yes, just down. It doesn't go anywhere else.
Hey, but physical matter can't go through it, so you're still breathing air.
Yeah, technically still breathing air.
So one-on-one stance.
Yep. Okay. That is his turn. Russell.
make a constitution saving throw.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. You will use legendary resistance.
You don't want to drop your axe.
No, not right now.
It won't. It'll just drop to the bottom. He has to get off the broom.
True.
Okay, so 5, 11. Okay, 15. So
15
halved.
Oh, okay.
15 is 20.
So. Yeah. Yeah. So that's what it is. I was looking for the word.
I forgot 7.
That's what I did. And then my best option at the moment is a nice little shatter. That's my best option.
Okay, no, wait,
as long as it's it's evocation.
So I sculpted around.
Okay. Constitution saving throw?
Yep.
My heck.
How can he fail?
16.
Oh yeah, he failed.
He's not saving on that one.
Oh, come on. You don't want to use both.
No.
Not when he's trapped with a monk.
Not when he's trapped with a monk. That's a terrible decision.
Well, it was crappy 12 thunder damage.
Well, he's not resistant to it, so...
That's what I figured. It's an odd resistance.
Right.
So...
I don't think I've ever made a monster with thunder resistance.
Yeah.
Like, not even a lightning. I don't think I gave it thunder resistance. Okay, that is... your turn. He's going to use a legendary action to smack you. With disadvantage.
Granted.
21.
Yes.
You're okay. Finished.
That is 11 plus 1, so 12 damage. Is he just whack?
How are you gonna get yourself out of this situation?
Either I go down or he continues going down.
Okay. That is Amora, you're up.
No, I haven't thought about it.
He's a guiding bolt.
Yeah, you could guiding bolt him easily.
He's out of range.
Oh, sorry.
He's well within range for that.
Oh yeah. Easily.
And I'm gonna do that.
You run over to the edge of the bow, and he's like, ah, crap.
Hmm. 32 damage.
32 damage?
Yes.
Pretty good, pretty good. Oh, roll that d20 one more time. Technically, you had advantage from his reckless attack.
Oh, yeah?
So you could technically get a crit.
24.
No? Check. Alright, just curious. Always that, always fish for crits.
That could have been devastating.
A crit guiding bolt is insane.
Oh yeah.
That's how she takes out the captains. It's when you roll a 20.
Okay, that is the end of your turn. Can't do anything in this stupid thing. Okay, he'll take another swing at you.
He could reach down and deactivate it.
Yeah, for take his action, but it's not his turn.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a 23 to hit. So you take another 12 damage.
You are gonna die.
He's just, I'm still standing.
He's just chipping away at your HP.
I can't heal you from that, actually. Unless I go down with you.
You can swim and breathe in water.
Yeah.
Okay, it is your turn, Thaddeus.
I jump from here on top of his shoulders.
Okay, easy enough to do. His metal is very warm.
It is very toasty, and it's very nice.
Your butt's just like, ooh!
New sensation.
Warmer!
Get off of me!
His body seems to be very conductive of the heat metal that is on his ass.
No.
It's distributing the heat so he doesn't take as much damage.
Exactly.
So okay. Take out the
axe
and take him out.
Take your hits.
Yeah. I'm gonna pound on this guy's head.
All of them are.
Am I annoying?
All of them are technically at advantage.
Yep. At advantage?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay, that's a 24.
Yep.
That is a 28.
Mm-hmm.
That was so close.
That'll teach him to reckless attack.
Well, I was hoping for good rolls, and I rolled a freaking 2.
It's a 20.
Yeah, it barely hits.
Oh, it was a nat 20, sorry. That's what I meant to say.
Oh, natural 20. Got it.
And then a 26.
Yes, they all hit.
Yes.
Pitiful.
Classic.
Classic monk.
So that's 4 plus 6 plus 7, and now crit. Oh, why did you have to throw a 1 in there? Twenty-four damage.
That was our.
That
half.
Is halved.
That's what I figured.
Yeah. Good thing he's taking half damage.
Oh, he would be gone.
He would have been done. That would have done it. 24.
Run as fast as you can.
Yes.
You can never escape me.
Thanks.
I'm the Captain Slayer.
That's a mora.
But it is now his turn. He reached down, grabbed the cube, deactivated as his freaking action.
How well can you swim?
I can swim.
Oh, he swims really good. He swims faster than most ships go.
Yeah, he can swim way fast.
randomly see.
I can almost run on water.
Pretty much. And then he just takes off in the water 30 feet.
With me!
Nah, oh yeah, you're
on top of
his head.
I thought you turned off your bubble.
He did turn off the bubble. He left the broom behind, though.
I'm on his shoulders.
He's just sitting on his shoulders. Yeah. He moves his 30 feet. That's all he can do for that.
Has anyone ever gone skiing and you lose control and you hold on to the handle as the boat is still going? That's how I am right now. But more guiding it. So it's more like...
Okay. All
right.
It is now your turn.
step over here.
You watch as he just like kind of like swims away.
Make a constitution save.
Ooh. Oh yeah, 30. No, 29.
All right.
Is he lighter? Oh,
almost max damage.
Impressive.
Oh. One under max damage.
Oh no.
That's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 damage. So halved is 11. Did he die?
You missed it by one.
Oh,
point.
That's okay. Shatter.
Shatter. Yeah, he's gone.
I create a pistol shrimp bubble in front of him.
He's just like going.
This vacuum opens up.
And he starts sinking underneath you, out from underneath you.
Am I able to pull him up and hoist him up?
With your ogre strength. Heel giant strength. I'd say you'd be able to get him to the surface of the water.
I'm okay with that.
That's as far up as you can get him.
I'm okay with that. I'm doing the lifeguard technique. Guys, help!
Just open a the hole underneath.
Oh yeah! Open the hole on the ship. Close it. Now I'm gonna go get my cube.
It takes you a minute, but you're able to get it.
This is all in the heat of the moment.
Oh yeah!
Cannon fire and everything.
Water's blowing up around you. You hear cheering up above you, but you have no idea what's going on. And then
I call my broom over to me and I go back up.
You go back up and get on board and you watch as there are dozens and dozens of ships just on fire and sinking.
I guess I didn't need to do a full shatter, but I did anyways. I could have used
anything.
Yeah, well, anything besides catapult, basically.
Hannah could have.
I could have used frost fear.
You could have used it. I would have wasted a legendary action just to avoid your catapult.
I'm so pissed. Okay. It would have been so worth the legendary resistance.
Oh, yeah. It's like, I still have one HP.
Well, and then you would have had to do with me.
Right. Flakes in the back of the head, goes unconscious. I found the Auschwitz, guys.
If you blink this little pipe, pink.
this particular scratch has a nice opening to the wiring harness.
If you stick your finger in long enough, you...
Sorry.
It's really hot in there.
The water helped cool it down.
But you see as the remaining pirates are going in under the island, and the flying ship is like kind of hovering for a while, like looks down and just flies off. You have defeated the Black Skull.
I need healing.
Finally, he needs healing.
I'm at half.
Finally, he needs healing.
Wait, I think he's fallen unconscious once.
Didn't he?
No.
No.
I swear.
I can do that.
No, the only one that's fallen unconscious is Jane. Multiple times.
Yes.
Thaddeus has avoided damage this entire campaign.
And now, I've been inside of all of the damage.
Yes, he's been at the forefront of all fights and has avoided most of the damage.
From what I know, at least for me, this is the most I've taken, at least to my knowledge.
Well, you have. This is the most
you've taken. Oh, yeah, this is the most any of you have taken.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, I think I might have taken more from the
Sea Hag and Elemental.
No, actually, the Cyborg did.
Oh, yeah, the Cyborg dude.
Yeah,
the Sea Hag wasn't, like, deadly. It was annoying, because I couldn't cast spells.
Yes.
And if I could, she would have been dead.
Oh, so fast.
So fast. And when I could, that's what happened.
She died. So fast.
We're reminiscing about all this as I'm getting back on the ship.
Blood starts in the water.
Man, yep. Overboard.
Blood starts going down my nose. Oh, That's oh. new.
That's new? I didn't know I bled.
I bleed red.
Half this crew has a god complex.
Oh, yeah. That's so true. I blame the captain.
What?
What?
I am humble.
The ships all start retreating into the dark as your fleet of ships from the guild start going in as well. On your map, you can see, just like at the corner, just at the very edge of your map, you can see several Navy ships going in as well. But you guys pull under the island, and as it starts to get dark, several miles in, you look up. Why are there stars? You're under an island.
The island isn't real. I knew it.
No, that's not it.
But you look closer and you can see the shape of the raven, the constellation up in the bottom of the island.
Oh, that's cool.
I mean, parts of it.
Yeah.
You wouldn't really be able to see the whole
thing. No, you wouldn't be able to see the whole thing.
We see the wing.
You'd be able to see part of the tail.
Yeah. You could probably see almost the full tail, but
yeah. Yeah, you'd be able to see the two on the tail.
Where did they put the paper?
There we go. You'd be able to see the two tail and then vaguely be able to see a couple more glowing dots.
So we need to go to the upper left. Yeah, wait.
So that is where we'll pick up next time. Well done defeating the Black Skull. May he rest in pieces within your knapsack.
I take
we'll
him
probably reprogram him later.
I'm keeping him up in my
Christmas. I can have him hunt down pirates.
Oh boy.
I'm an artificer.
That is fact. It's like I've worked on one of these things before.
Right.
Change the mind of this big robot.
Right now he is in my crow's nest.
Yeah, point.
Yeah. You helped her several times.
Yeah. I know how to fix these.
Yes. Strike it with lightning. Just dusk.
That's how I'll bring it back.
It's a knife.
Actually. More? No. It's an object. Not a living thing.
Oh. Yeah.
It's an object right now.
Yeah, he is an object right now.
He's my new mascot. As I'm sitting up in the crow's nest. Hey!
Don't damage that, I want him.
That's fine, I won't damage him. He'll just be waving at everyone.
You have to remember he is 10 feet tall and nearly a ton.
No, he's sitting and I'm taking one arm.
Oh.
Hey!
He is very big. But yes, that is where we'll end. Join us next time for Isekai, most likely. And we shall go from there.
We'll see you next week's brains.
Adventure on.
Bye!